Fans of Fiction, I'm your host, Gene Skinner. Weeb will be joining us eventually. He's on the toilet. he told me that himself before we started, so he'll get here when he gets here. So let's get right into it and watch the show. Here we go. Cover some Warhammer memes.
Congratulations. You've been chosen by the Administratum to undertake our special repopulation program. Your new holy duty would be to endlessly sire children with the most powerful women in the Imperium. And you do this, you shall be richly rewarded.
So not only do I get paid, but I get to lay with highborn chicks every day? Without protection?
Yes.
Sweet! So when do I get started?
Why, right now.
Hey ladies, sorry to keep you waiting. The Emp's greatest gift has finally... arrived?
Got assassins! That's right.
Welcome, traveler!
Put this
the
one
name
for
is
Weeb.
Itsu. We have the goods if you can pay the coin!
Oh boy, Kitsune.
It's not going to be cheap!
Hey! I'm not even working at this time of the year. But I guess for so many coins, I can make an exception.
Wow.
Prepare the item for you in just a moment. Oh, I see you're eager to order more. Sure, we can do that. Let's wait for Big Sis to show up first, shall we?
Oh, it's time for some
the
lore.
Empire stands as the largest and most powerful realm in the old world. It is a reflection of human resilience and ingenuity. In a world of constant peril and wonder, its vast lands and provinces are as diverse as they are rich in history and culture. This grand expanse is a mosaic of landscapes, each with its own unique challenges and secrets. What follows is a collection of works by yours truly, Dr. Stefan Hoffman from the University of Nam. In this episode, we will continue our travels through the lands and provinces of the Empire. I am accompanied by my friend Wilhelm Adler, who is on a quest of great personal urgency. Wilhelm's sister, residing in the heart of Talabekland's capital, Talabhai, has fallen victim to a mysterious and ravaging illness.
Oh boy.
Our journey is not solely driven by the quest for healing. As we traverse the rich landscapes of Talabekland, we also immerse ourselves in the province's deep cultural tapestry and its pivotal role within the Empire. From the dense whispering woods of the Great Forest to the bustling streets of Talabhai. As we cross the border into Talabekland, the landscape unfolded before us to reveal countless shades of green. I had never been to this place before, and I was amused and convinced that the forest had more than earned its name, the Great Forest. The dense expanse of it stretched as far as the eye could see, its ancient trees standing tall. As we made our way towards Talabhai, the capital city cradled by the forest, I was struck by the vibrancy of life that coursed through the province. Farmers tended to their crops with care. Merchants traveled the roads with their wares. We found ourselves enveloped in the natural majesty of this province, a contrast to the haunted ruins of Mordheim we had left behind. Walking under the shadows of enormous trees, Wilhelm and I shared what we knew about the Great Forest and the province. Spanning vast distances of wild, uncharted territory, the forest serves as a sanctuary for a myriad of beings, both natural and unnatural. It is a preferred hideout for bandits and outlaws wishing to elude the grasp of Imperial law, who often conceal their camps beneath the dense canopy of trees.
I'm gonna guess beastmen are here.
Deep within the forest's heart, greenskin tribes and beastmen warlords
that was right.
stake their claims over extensive areas, territories that the Imperial armies find challenging to identify and cleanse. Additionally, the forest is notoriously recognized as a refuge for groups of chaos followers, remnants of forces once vanquished during earlier incursions into the Empire, or newly founded cults that praise the Dark Gods. It is important to note, though, that the Great Forest, while it is home to many dangers, is not as perilous as the Drakwald Forest or the Forest of Shadows. While the Great Forest envelops much of Talabekland, significant portions have been cleared to establish farmlands or to support the Empire's growing demand for timber, fueling its burgeoning lumber industry. Similar to other wooded areas across the Empire, swaths of forest have also been removed to pave the way for infrastructure developments, including roads, villages, and towns. Despite these alterations, the forest remains expansive, covering a large area of the Central Empire. The River Talabek, one of the great rivers of the Empire, serves as a vital artery that flows through the province, marking its importance not just geographically, but also historically.
You're gonna learn some lore today, Porky. That's what's going on right now. If you're writing on Weeb.
Originating from the World's Edge Mountains, this majestic river meanders through the dense and ancient woodlands of the Great Forest before coursing past the city of Talabheim and eventually joining the River Rike. Over the centuries, it has fostered trade and sustenance for the people of Talabekland, becoming a bustling trade route that connects the inner provinces of the Empire to the eastern frontiers. Merchant ships and trade barges laden with goods from lumber to grain ply its waters, weaving a network of commerce. Beyond its economic significance, the River Talabek is steeped in legend and lore. It is said that the gods themselves have walked its banks, and battles fought over its control have altered the course of history. The river has been both a protector, with its daunting width and depth serving as a natural barrier against invaders, and a challenge for those seeking to bridge its expanse.
The River Talabek is the main artery that brings life to the heart of the Great Forest. For centuries, the woodsmen of Talabek have used the river to transport timber, charcoal, pelts and other goods out of the depths of the Great Woods. If you want to choke the people of this region, you need only to stop the flow of goods from the river.
Oh, there he is. Let us answer Weeb.
Hello!
There we are,
stand
hi.
As the most expansive
we're
city
hearing
in the
all about
Talabekland of the
right
Empire.
Now.
Nestled deep within
oh,
the
I Talabekland, all right.
of the Empire's great forest.
Well, we're feeling worse for wear cause of it.
That's right.
Of the forest. This monarchy.
How you doing, Skinner Jeans?
Doing fine.
Of a formidable
got a little bit of a playlist for us tonight.
As the
not
city
long,
itself
we'll
is situated within
we
a vast
will manage
shadow
some
right.
that I think you will enjoy in here too, obviously.
Serving as
don't
a beacon of tranquility surrounded by...
Well, I enjoy everything except for Porky's movie time. Fucking got him.
Porky, you
I might be sick, but got you, Porcus Pigus.
You pig. Its inhabitants.
You pig.
The city teams
you American pig dog.
With a constant flurry of events and attractions.
Pig you doggeroo.
Both locals and visitors alike. The vibrancy persists even in the quieter districts.
I might have gnomes kicking my stomach about Porky, but at least I'm not a pig Pollock. For sure.
Got him. The streets, often too narrow for individuals...
Anything else going on in the Geneverse?
Much less for the passage
of
cars or wagons, are perpetually filled with a diverse crowd
oh, fuck
of
yeah.
laborers and nobility.
Did you hunt them spirits? Haste.
We did. I'm the one who died most. Genova ran away most of the time, and I got killed by the spirits.
Arriving yeah, that the sounds about like an average experience.
Yeah. We did
get. Did you hear the horrible news?
Oh no! What happened?
Talabheim was a fortress. Female custodians confirmed.
Its gates welcomed us into
streets alive with the. If you're still part of the fandom, get out now before it becomes Star Wars.
Yeah, wasn't. My friend told me about the history of this.
No, they are. Sons of imperial noble families.
That's right. As the legends
go. Not daughters. Mm-hmm. Not. Have you ever hello, it's me, the Golden Hole. Yeah. No.
No.
It's a saga that stretches back to the age
it's
of
an
legends.
Old woman.
After Tal, the god of nature, Tal. Bestowed upon his
there
brother
is, man.
Ulrich
leave
the mountain.
Leave my yard, old man god.
He ventured eastward.
Get off my
newest,
lawn. Deep
into newest the edition of the Codex, Nathan. It very clearly says, Her Command Bridge, Captain
as
General... Bitch's labius, or whatever her name is.
Tal came upon a massive worm.
A massive worm.
Creature.
A dragon.
Such ferocity kind of. That it dared...
A worm.
A worm.
Their battle was epic, lasting weeks, with the very
I show Tal my worm, now he won't respond.
In the climax of their confrontation, Tal seized the beast by its tail, striking it against the ground so fiercely that he carved out the western reaches of the Talabek River.
Oh, lore.
With a final monumental effort, Tal hurled the worm into the skies.
Whee!
Its flaming Eat body it. Descending.
All does it, everyone worships him. I whip out my worm and oh, you're a sex pest.
Rather than a scene of destruction. Tal found that the worm's remains
or had
enriched the crater's soil, making it incredibly fertile. Even
the
beast's scales,
too,
mingling with the earth, became a source of magical material prized for crafting.
Magical material.
Looking upon this crater, Tal named it Talahim,
Talahim.
Or Tal's Victory, foreseeing that it would someday nurture a thriving community.
Hey, whoa.
To ensure that they could reach
Hi,
this
Dakota.
Blessed land, he crafted a great tunnel through the crater's walls.
How's it going?
Wilhelm's explanation captivated me, and the story actually explained why things are the way they are in this city.
Do they though?
Are you sure about that?
I think it's
the
just
interior
a,
of the crater
a myth,
encompasses a vast expanse that houses not only fertile agricultural lands, but also a lake brimming with fresh water. Alongside the majestic city itself. This ensures that, in the event of a formidable adversary managing to penetrate the defenses of Talabeklan's forces, the city and its resilient inhabitants can endure a prolonged siege with relative self-sufficiency, protected by the imposing walls of the Great Crater. As long as these natural fortifications hold against the invaders, the people within have the resources to withstand an extended assault. Talabheim is considered to be one of the safest places within the Empire.
Wow. So safe. So secure.
I hear that a lot.
As Wilhelm and I made our way through the streets of this unique city, the hint of
iron within
between
iron.
Us was powerful.
That's right.
Our destination was the home of Audrey Adler, Wilhelm's sister, who had succumbed to the mysterious illness. Upon our arrival, we were greeted by a scene of quiet concern. Audrey
just
lay in bed, her brow glistening with the sheen of fever, a local physician attending to her. The doctor, a man with a steady demeanor, turned to us as we entered.
You've come at a crucial time. This sickness, where not yet widespread, is beginning to show more frequently within the city and in several surrounding areas. We're seeing an increasing number of cases, much
like
Audrey's here.
Bring out the holy hot pocket.
The symptoms are consistent fever, severe fatigue, and in some cases, what's perplexing is the sudden onset and the rapid progression in certain patients.
We've all been there.
We're doing all we can.
Hey,
but I must admit, this illness is unlike anything we've encountered.
Let he, without the Nurgle rod, throw the first stone.
Closer to his sister's bedside.
Not a pustule at all.
Silently observing, my mind racing with
questions. That's right.
And theories.
We're no better than the communists.
It was clear that this sickness was more
than a
mere ailment. It was a puzzle that needed solving.
For Father Nurgle.
Share Nurgle's love. Give your friends STDs today.
And potentially the wider empire.
2 days later.
In the heart of Talabine, amidst the growing unease caused by the mysterious illness, a breakthrough was made by a local healer who had been tirelessly documenting the spread of the sickness. Through meticulous analysis, a chilling pattern emerged, pointing directly to the city's water supply as a likely conduit for the malady. This discovery prompted the city's authorities to take immediate action, deploying a hunting force composed of local scouts.
Am I muscular or fashionable? You'll never know.
Guard, the regiment that manned the crater wall. These hunters, adept at navigating the dense and treacherous woods surrounding Talabime, set out with a singular purpose. Their intimate knowledge of the forest's hidden path and secretive byways, honed through years of vigilant defense of the city's borders, guided them swiftly through the wilderness. Upon reaching the water source, the scouts encountered a grotesque scene. A band of chaos cultists, their bodies twisted with mutations and branded with the sickening marks of Nurgle, were caught in the act of corrupting the stream.
You're just bad, you don't have a back friend.
A sinister chaos cult dedicated to Nurgle,
he has a stomach friend too.
Chaos god of pestilence and decay.
I don't trust stomach friend. Back friend? You know he's got your back.
Overwhelmed stomach friend by the grief and despair born from the constant presence.
Or like take a shit in your soup. You don't know.
In their delusion,
you can't trust front friend.
These unfortunate souls are led to believe that Nurgle provides a form of salvation.
I mean, he does, but
offering either relief from
insight
into the scourges
people,
of disease and inevitable decay that marks the human condition. Unbeknownst to them, their misguided faith merely strengthens Nurgle's dominion, perpetuating an endless cycle of affliction.
I love that cycle, though. It's kind
of natural.
The
prevalence of different illnesses across the empire makes uncovering the cults dedicated to Nurgle a challenging task. This difficulty arises not only from their tendency to remain inconspicuous, assimilating seamlessly with the local populace, but also from their habit of constantly relocating to hidden lairs, abandoned places, or somewhere deep in the forests. These strategies enable them to evade detection and continue their nefarious activities. But
that's
these
cool
damned
art.
Bastards,
that
most
cool
likely
art.
They're responsible for the strange.
You know, mine is the titty clamps.
Oh,
the
yeah, that's a little out there. That looks very splendid.
Red-handed.
Instead of Nurgle.
A fierce confrontation ensued, pitting the city's
Big Father, what should I wear today? Pierce your nipples. Do it.
Chaos followers, although fanatical,
just do
match
it.
For the disciplined might of Talabime's defenders.
Stop being a tease
the
and pierce those titties.
With the cultists
you know what, Nurgle? I think I'm going to call it a day.
Along with a cache of documents, weapons, and other damning evidence of
He's
their
seen
activities.
Some shit.
Yes. I think he probably only
the
has
document
that
seized
now.
From the cultists unveiled a sinister plot far
cool.
greater.
What if the other one works just fine, but like
fear.
The guy who made the hood's like, I'm not cutting
an
another hole, dude.
Was being
you paid for
the
one.
Poisoning
yeah,
of the water supply
money,
and the dissemination
guy.
Of disease Come serving
right.
as
I hate to break it
to
you, but
Talabime's formidable defenses. The cultists aim to sow chaos and despair.
I like that art.
Softening the city from within.
Oh, look at that.
Vulnerable
to
their impending assault. Armed
shit.
With this
Look
knowledge,
really
the authorities
nice.
In Talabime acted swiftly to address the contamination of the water supply, while also bolstering the city's
defenses.
What's
really funny about the whole female custodian thing is like all these fucking casuals are like, well, there's nothing in the lore that says that they can make female custodians. I'm like, oh, other than every piece of art, every description mm-hmm. ever of custodians being a brotherhood, mm-hmm. the emperor's first and finest sons. Mm-hmm. No. Well, you know. Well, they could have a female. Why?
The process of strengthening the city's defenses.
Like, oh, they're like, well, they're gene-bred, so they're gonna be stronger than normal humans. Yeah, but why would you want a weak base bottle?
We know that Talavine was built
like, there's plenty of strong women in the franchise. There's no need to make them custodians, because it opens the door to female space marines.
Marks the boundary. They want that more and more every day.
The Tal Bastion is a district within Talabine.
But, you know, that's fine. Go ahead. Pander to these weirdos. See what happens when they, don't buy any models like I would. Structures,
originating from the natural ramparts of the colossal crater, the rim of defenses has undergone continuous reinforcement.
Bundles of sticks.
Enhancement over the centuries by the diligent efforts of the city's military forces. The relentless commitment to fortification has transformed it into an impregnable barrier. The smaller outposts dotting the perimeter of defenses are colloquially known as lashes. Each lash is staffed by the dedicated garrison of 30 soldiers and is armed with an array of nearly a dozen cannons and
ballistas. Oh man, I can't believe they garrisoned the lash with
while
one of 30 soldiers. Poor
well
girl.
Well equipped to harry opposing forces attempting to breach the perimeter from both outside and within, their primary role is to serve as an early detection system for any approaching threat to Talabine.
No female Stody, says Nathan in all caps.
To communicate...
Oh, with your wallet. Vault with your wallet. 3D print all your models.
Signal rockets, which are launched into the sky in a
variety of colors. I'm more mad about this than the death
intensities.
Of Emperor's TTS.
The defenders are trained to know what
at least we got something out of, you know, out of the death of that.
That's true.
The unique combinations of these signals...
What are we getting out of this? Nothing.
...time information to both the defenders...
Hello, it's me, Sister Captain Biggest Flitus. And I'm here to save the Emperor.
Ensuring a swift
and coordinated
response to any threat.
Exactly! Already
have those! Central exactly.
Have you said, oh, hey, by the way, the Sisters of the Silence got rolled up into the custodies and they just used custodian ranks. That I would be okay with.
Exactly.
They've been hand in hand for 10,000 years.
Which runs along the entire rim of the crater, connecting the watch post with one another.
I want my big, muscly gold women.
As the customs office,
which normally I'd be all for. But when you fuck with lore, I won't tolerate it.
Fortifications encircling Talabine's crater wall stand vigil, equipped with an impressive arsenal of formidable weaponry. Beyond the familiar silhouettes of great cannons and mortars, which already promise a deadly welcome to any would-be aggressors, there lie the innovative creations of the College of Engineers. These experimental armaments, born from the ingenuity and inventiveness of the Empire's finest minds, add an unpredictable edge to Talabine's defenses, showcasing the city's readiness to blend traditional martial strength with cutting-edge advancements of engineering. The Talabine military is distinguished by its significant number of archers relative to standard
infantry.
Crossbow
archers too, damn.
Reflecting its strategic emphasis on ranged combat, this force is renowned for its agility and speed in navigating the dense, wooded areas that surround and permeate the city. The majority of its soldiers are drawn from the surrounding forests and glens.
DTF down to fight.
Among the footmen that have been trained mostly for melee combat, there is a marked preference for axes and spears over swords, a result of their adaptation to the unique demands of warfare in forested terrain.
Well, yeah, that makes sense.
Founded after a remarkable victory during a crusade, the Knights of the Blazing Sun are dedicated to Mimidia,
look at that armor.
The goddess of war.
Oh, yeah.
They bear armor and barding of black and gold,
that's cool,
or sometimes
shit.
Yellow. A variety stylized sun symbols are used on banners, and sometimes painted or engraved on barding.
That's right.
That's awesome.
These knights have founded their temple in Talabine.
Well, they're fighting lizardmen.
The Knights of the Blazing Sun are a small elite order of Templars devoted to the study and mastery of the science and art of warfare. These knights value ability and accomplishment over all other factors, including noble birth.
No.
It is because of this that the Order has grown in prosperity, attracting the finest military minds to its battle.
Hell yeah.
A Knight of the Blazing Sun's primary goal is to obtain perfection in the art of war. As such, they travel the Old World individually, seeking battle both large and small. All in all, the city of Talabheim stands strong against any invader who would dare to attack it.
Bum, bum, bum.
I was surprised by the many engineering inventions, deadly traps, and strategies of defense they had at their disposal.
We're gonna march.
Right.
Unfortunately, Audrey was not to survive the strain that had her suffering for some time now. Before her untimely
happens to the best of us.
Audrey,
I've been there. I got better though.
Confided in Wilhelm by giving him a sealed letter.
She turned me into a note. Trusting him with got better.
Delivery to her beloved spouse, who resided in the nearby province of Hockland. As Talabekland braced itself against the looming threat of a chaos invasion, Wilhelm found himself entrenched in the crucial tasks of fortifying the city's defenses, believing his efforts
were indispensable in safeguarding the city.
He expressed a heartfelt reluctance to leave, feeling his talents and leadership were needed more than ever to orchestrate the defense against the encroaching darkness. Understanding Wilhelm's dilemma and the weight of the responsibility he bore, I, Dr. Stefan Hoffman, stepped forward. Moved by Audrey's final wish and the deep bond of friendship, I offered to undertake the journey in Wilhelm's stead. It was not just a matter of duty, but a profound obligation to honor Audrey's memory and fulfill her last request. This commitment set my path towards Hockland, a heavily wooded province bounded by the Middle Mountains to the northeast, and adjacent to the lands of Ostland, a province that lives in a state of near constant war. Join me as we journey onward, across the rolling hills and through the dense forests.
Thank you, Imperial Attenborough.
Yes.
There, new discoveries await, the challenges of uncharted paths, and the tales of those who call these
and demons home. Unfucked. Go join me on my next journey when I go to the realm of Sonesh.
The resilience and valor that define the
land. Oh yeah, I've been there.
This
is Dr. Stefan Hoffman. This has been our journey.
Moving on. Speaking of Warhammer, here we go. Weave, this for you.
We've all missed you very much over the past 3 years, Brother Demetrius. But we understand the importance of your mission to bring the light of the Emperor to the far reaches of the galaxy.
Thank you, Candidus. I miss you all too.
Oh, your hair has grown so much.
Maybe I should shave my head like before.
Nope, they don't want him to cut his hair.
Don't you do it!
Oh shit! Dragon time. Dragon Tamer.
Dragon Ham.
Hey, boss.
Universal.
Seems like you're not part of the family photo.
Mm-hmm.
Leave it to me. I'll take it for you.
Oh, how nice of you.
Yoink! You fell for it.
Oh, man. You people are too easy. Can't believe you fell for that.
Yeah, that's a bad idea, bud.
Family of fighters.
Well done, my young dragons.
They all just flew at him. All right, time for some.
He's lucky. I would have just kept on stomping.
Up here we go. Crash medical music.
What have we got?
Hey guys, this video is sponsored by NVIDIA and MSI.
Hey, that's
so
my computer.
Make sure to stick around until the end of the video for a breakdown on their new top tier MSI Titan.
Hey, that's that computer that I spiked before we sent it out to its unwilling customer.
I don't have a Titan.
Series that most people are probably
reading. Yeah, sure.
Capcom's original 1996 masterpiece inspired a whole genre of games for decades.
I can't believe you play nothing but Dead or Alive Beach Volleyball every day, Gene.
But a lot of what Resident Evil
I like the storyline.
Prior on the PC,
yeah,
huh?
The storyline.
1992 PC game, which also featured puzzle solving, fixed camera angles, not to mention a whole spooky mansion to explore. Plus, it also featured Lovecraftian lore before that stuff was overused and obnoxious. It went on to create an entire franchise of its own to...
I can't believe Porky just admitted he beat Jenny. Like, man, I wouldn't be so proud about beating on women, dude. That's kind of fucked, Pork.
That is,
well, she
until
is French
now.
And Canadian,
because
so.
Here we are in 2024.
Then never mind, you're justified. I apologize for bothering you.
Alone in the Dark, reboot or reimagining...
Please keep up the good work, sir.
PC Interactive.
Who?
Whose only other real claim to fame is a couple of expansion packs for Titan Quest.
Me.
Polish pig is what he is.
For having low expectations when you go into this one. I mean, I know I sure did.
Hey.
But what pleasantly surprised me is that I soon realized those concerns were misguided. On account of...
Daddy Skywalker, no. I hate you!
I mean, it's not amazing or flawless, and it's definitely not on the same caliber or scale as the recent Resident Evil remakes. But this just feels like a game that knows exactly what
it
is.
You are my brother, Porkerkin!
Are, and it never tries to do more than it can handle. And despite a few hiccups here and there, it was a mostly solid experience from beginning to end that I more or less played through in a couple of sittings.
Well, in that case, have a seat. Let me make you a drink.
The story again focuses on those original two main characters, Emily Hartwood and Edward Carmby. The story is that Emily and Edward are heading to a mental institution named Deserto Manor to check up on Emily's uncle Jeremy, who's had a long history of mental illness. Jeremy is convinced he's possessed by a figure called the Dark Man, not to be confused with the Sam Raimi film with the same name.
Same, buddy. Same.
Don't drink it.
And he sent Emily a letter, which appears to be a veiled cry for help. And look, if survival horror has taught me anything, it's that you're better off just ignoring letters you receive from loved ones.
I got a letter.
Anyway, much like the set of Manor was in the original game, this is a large, ominous structure surrounded by the wilderness. And when Emily and Edward arrive, the entire place appears to be deserted.
Let's just find him first.
However, after breaking in and snooping around for a bit, they run into the many residents, all who act a bit weird and detached.
This is private property. You can't just barge in here.
Not in like a
my,
or an evil way.
Got on my body says
kind of
I can do whatever the fuck I want, lady.
You'd expect to see in a mental health facility.
Who is your uncle, darling?
Jeremy. Am I right?
Soon turns out that Jeremy's gone missing and the staff don't know where he is. And after going through his room and his belongings, it appears there's a lot more going on here than meets the eye, taking a supernatural turn soon after.
Oh, wow.
That's creepy.
That's striking.
And it's all kind of similar to the original game, with the backdrop of Deserto and Jeremy's character being core components to the story.
Oh, fuck, a pirate!
I mean, the little girl named Grace was also a key figure in the sequel, Alone in the Dark 2. Oh. And the ending even kind of hints that we might be seeing a bit more of her character if a sequel for this remake is ever developed. There's even one scene later on where it uses the fixed camera placement from the original game. And if you've got the deluxe edition, you can turn on the same character models from the original 1990.
Wow, look at that. Look at that pixelated mess.
Yeah. Oh, look at that dumpy.
Like the original game, you're again given the option to play.
Oh, man, they made her ugly as shit with no ass.
Things, this really doesn't change all that much. Edward acts like your typical hard-boiled, liquor-soaked private investigator, smoking cigarettes and swilling booze, and he more or less interrogates everyone he comes into contact with.
What can you tell me?
Call me Johnny. Johnny Noir.
Johnny Noir.
I wouldn't want to go into details about his condition.
No relation.
Johnny Hard Rock.
Whereas Emily seems much more distant.
They call me Johnny Hardstone.
Good evening, there you go. Hartwood.
Either way,
but you
though,
can call me
Lil
Pete.
How does that make it?
How does that make any sense? Just don't worry about it. Call me that.
Now listen to my SoundCloud.
Me? You're the one who just disappeared.
You heard my sick diss track?
How did you?
Against.
Where did you go?
Never mind. No.
I was just talking to Dr. Gray.
You disappear.
I mean, during that arrival to Deserto, for
felt
instance,
better to that.
After you first run into the maid, if you're playing as Edward, he basically just forces himself up the stairs so he can investigate Jeremy's room.
Excellent. Thank you, madam.
Whereas if you're playing as Emily, the maid is a bit more receptive to their inquiries, and then they're even more or less just let right in soon after by Grace.
Follow me.
But regardless of which one you've gone with, you still end up searching through his belongings in his room minutes later. So that overall outcome is still going to be the same. And even the puzzles, and more importantly, the puzzle solutions, are the exact same for each playthrough. There are some unique cinematics for each character, and even a whole unique sequence they each get, which unveils a bit of their backstory before they came to Deserto. but it's definitely not quite in the same vein as the kind of thing we got in the Resident Evil 2 remake, you know, where you got to play as either Leon or Claire.
Welcome to the madhouse, detective.
Still though, there is still a good reason to play through both stories, because along the way you're always collecting these unique items, some of which can be only found in that character's campaign. And if you're a witch, you actually unlock hidden endings.
So it gives
them
more replayability.
Aside from that though, there's also minor gameplay differences. For instance, Emily gets an automatic pistol, whereas Edward has a revolver. And she does seem to be slightly faster than he does when sprinting. Yeah, dog, like where that main story is concerned, you're still getting the exact same experience regardless of who you're playing as. And either way, it doesn't take too long before that supernatural shit hits the fan. Because it seems old Jeremy's gone and got himself locked away in some kind of alternate reality. I mean, yeah, what a dumbass.
This can't be.
Well, it is kind of cool in that way,
yeah,
too.
Like, no, again, no one here has ever done that before.
Shifting things up as you suddenly teleport into this frightening, nightmarish version of the real world. And the way that the other characters seem aware of the whole thing, but also a bit aloof, keeps that whole premise really interesting.
You know, surprise bags, Carpet.
Kind of reminds me a lot of Silent Hill 2, where everyone you talk to seems to be lost in their own little
world. Oh, no, keep doing it. You don't need your feet.
Share it.
No.
Are you blind or something?
Another big part of why I enjoyed playing
fucking forehead.
Is because, unlike a certain other recent third-person horror game I played,
I wish I was blind so I couldn't see all five of that head.
Down with constant cinematics and exposition. You're left to your own devices for lengthy periods of time to explore the manor and look for all the clues and important items.
What do we got here?
You'll eventually find shortcuts
to
that
page turn sounded
time spent
wet. I didn't like that.
And I found that that kind of thing made it impossible to put down, because it felt like every time I was about to stop playing and take a break, I'd find some new key or item.
I'll be right back, Gene. Don't kill nobody.
I'm sure you promise this time.
You can also tailor just how easy or hard you want to make the puzzles as well. Being able to turn things on, like visual clues or icons on the map to help you out. But then you can also just turn all of this stuff off if you want to figure the whole thing out for yourself. Oh yeah, and I gotta say too, how I love how they've included a pair of bolt cutters. And I'm absolutely convinced at this point that there's like some kind of unwritten law between all these game devs that dictates that if you're making a survival horror game, you have
just
to have a pair
cutters
of bolt
and
cutters.
You need
I will just say though, if you're going to turn off all those assistance features, well, then you also might want to keep a pen and paper handy, because some of the puzzles are incredibly complex and confusing. In fact, off the back of that, like, there is a bit of inconsistency in that regard, and I found that the puzzles were often absurdly easy, you know, to the point where, like, the item you need to get past something is literally an arm's length away from the object itself. But then on the other hand, certain puzzles are so incredibly vague, and the solution even more obscure, that when I ended up solving them, I was kind of dumbfounded that what I tried actually worked. I'll just say too, that if you don't like trying to figure out safe combinations, you know, four or five times, well, this ain't the game for you either. Visually too, Alone in the Dark has a lot of fantastic moments. There's some really creepy imagery here and there throughout the campaign, making good use of the lighting and the sound design to heighten the mood. The whole running theme is that you're using this talisman to unlock portals, which lets you explore all these different memories, and this has let them have a lot of variety to the environments. I mean, outside of the manor itself, you've got the dimly lit streets of New Orleans, you've got a swamp, a cemetery, underground crypts, an otherworldly library, and a dockyard drenched in thick fog. Should be worth noting too though that this is not a big budget AAA experience, and you'll definitely notice a few weaker aspects to the presentation, like the mirrors for instance, which is the absolute litmus test for figuring out if a game is using the Unreal Engine. The biggest one though is how all of the character models look.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, you're not wrong.
Now, I mean, it's no big secret that Edward is modeled after David Harbour and Emily is modeled after Jodie Comer. And what this means is that these two characters look like people, because obviously their likeness has been scanned across. Everyone else, though, looks like a video game character, and they're not at all to the same level of detail and consistency. Now, this is not an overall bad thing, but it is just the expected outcome, I guess, when you've only got the budget to properly scan two people into your game.
That's unacceptable.
There is also a bit of tonal whiplash as well in terms of the overall atmosphere, because you'll often go from exploring some kind of genuinely scary environment, you know, being chased after by literal monsters, only for the environment to then snap back to reality, oops, there goes gravity, and suddenly you're having this bizarre conversation with someone in broad daylight, while this quirky jazz music plays in the background.
A few moments later.
Are you sure you want to? We could stay here and drink the night away.
What?
Towards the end of the story, it does go from day to night, and things do feel a bit more sinister. But it just never seems to maintain that horror tone as much early on, which is a bit of a shame. Because when the game is doing its best to unnerve you, I gotta say, man, it does a bang-up fucking job of it. The good news, too, is that you're not going to be spending all your time just running around looking for items, making small talk and reading people's diaries. And Alone in the Dark manages to offer up enough combat so the whole thing stays interesting. And this stuff right here is proper old-school survival horror shooting controls. That being, you move like a slow, lumbering asshole, where raising a weapon, aiming and firing all can cost precious seconds, along with the reload times being just that little bit longer than you'd like. All of which, though, is absolutely by design. And about the fastest you'll ever be moving is when you're trying to dodge, where your character awkwardly kind of propels themselves around to avoid attacks. And I really do feel like this kind of thing is going to make or break the experience for a lot of people, but I gotta say that I absolutely love this kind of approach, especially in survival horror. I mean, you're not playing as a special forces soldier or a Navy SEAL, you're just a regular person who has the advantage of knowing how to fire a gun. And the speed of the combat feels like it reflects that perfectly.
Surprise, motherfucker!
You don't refill your health by using medkits, bandages, or red potions. You instead get it back by taking a swig from your hip flask. Yeah, like a real man or woman.
Don't mind if I do.
Weapons have just the right amount of impact when firing, and the sound design is loud and eardrum rupturing, making it feel like every shot is truly meaningful, which it is.
Which it is.
Is it going to win any awards or leave a sticky puddle on my chair, though? Well, no, but it's fun and it's functional, which is really all it ever needed to be. It's also a weapon lineup that's clearly gone for quality over quantity, with there only being three main weapons in total. You've got the pistol or the revolver, the shotgun, classic, and then finally, a Tommy gun.
A Tommy gun!
Oh, yeah.
Both characters start off with a pistol or revolver, along with a handful of ammo, and in fact you need to find three specific items before you're even able to access the shotgun in the first place. And then the Tommy gun doesn't even show up until about maybe two-thirds into the game, with a dynamic crosshair and recoil that realistically depicts just how well someone might actually shoot that thing in real life. Apart from that, there's also an abundance of melee weapons you can use as well, like sledgehammers, shovels, and pipes. Though the melee system really is just a little more than button mashing and kinda hoping for the best. And then finally, there's also the option to pick up random objects from around the environment to throw at enemies, what the game calls opportunities. And it is a bit weird that you can't hold onto these things, because once you pick them up, you can't seem to put them down without throwing them. But some of these are really effective, like all the Molotov cocktails that someone was nice enough to just leave laying around. And even those bottles of alcohol can be ignited when shot at, making them useful for setting traps for the enemies. Oh yeah, speaking of the enemies, the ones you come up against here are these horrific, disgusting creatures that seem to just literally come out of the darkness.
Ew.
With appendages and other growths coming out of their body, making them barely recognizable. And outside of these flying bat things, which are beyond fucking annoying, they all seem well balanced and never feel outright cheap or frustrating to fight. The game describes standard difficulty as the intended experience, which is what I went through for my first playthrough, but even on the so-called standard mode, you still lose a lot of health when enemies hit you. In fact, it's actually more akin, I think, to what hard mode is in most other games.
Oh, shit!
So yeah, don't get me wrong, these things are still going to kick the ever-loving shit out of you. And it's surprisingly easy to get overwhelmed and killed. And in fact, at certain instances, you're outright forced to run past them entirely, or even just avoid them. Which kind of does showcase that really crappy stealth system, where your character does what wouldn't even pass as a full squat, and walks incredibly slowly to avoid detection. But I found that most of the time, just having general game sense, along with staying mobile and timing my reloads, was all I needed to get through most encounters. And overall, like, I found the combat to be a really fun component to the experience, with the speed of the movement and the gunplay feeling just right for the kind of game it's trying to be. It's like I said, like, you're not playing as Chris Redfield or Jill Valentine. You're either a middle-aged alcoholic private detective or a 30-something-year-old woman who looks like she'd get trapped under a broom handle. And if you can accept that that's the kind of combat you're going to be dealing with and appreciate it on that level, well, then there's a lot of tension and enjoyment that comes from that.
It's hard to explain.
The only real challenging moment I had was the final boss, which isn't like impossible, but it's because this fight is so much more intense than anything you've done prior. It'd be like playing Mike Tyson's Punch-Out and going from taking on Glass Joe to then skipping right ahead to Mike himself. I should also mention too that this was a far from bug-free affair, and I experienced a whole lot of glitches and issues throughout my playtime. The most common one is just the amount of times I got stuck in the environment, which was really annoying. Other bugs included not being able to swing or pick up melee weapons, along with not being able to interact with the environment at all. Then of course there's that old chestnut where the game just randomly crashed to desktop, which annoyingly would often happen before the autosave even kicked in. Performance-wise, there's also some serious stuttering going on as well, which is incredibly noticeable and even kind of ruins some of those transitions.
What the hell was that?
But apparently the devs are supposed to be working on a fix for that, so hopefully by the time most people are hearing my voice, this has been resolved.
What the hell is going on?
A lot of the other stuff was also fixed anyway if I just loaded up an old save file. And thankfully too, the devs were smart enough to include save points.
Welcome
what
back.
Exactly does that mean?
And look,
thank
I don't
you.
Know if I really
no
need
thanks
to
the porky and
the
his Nurgleite.
A manual save option, but either way, just take my word for it.
They did.
Right in there.
All up, finishing Edward's campaign took me around 6 or so hours, and then finishing Emily soon after took me another 3.5. I did still miss quite a few of those hidden collectibles.
You think I got it rough, you see what I did to those guys.
Those endings, so there would be value going back in again and finding all that stuff. Speaking of endings, I would absolutely love to spoil what happens here as well, because it really does seem to come out of absolutely nowhere, but
what
in the best
here?
Possible way. All I'll say is that fans of the original, along with Quake fans of all people,
Quake?
Are going to find themselves living out that Leonardo DiCaprio meme in real time. Overall, Alone in the Dark is the kind of game that doesn't do a whole heap of things, but what it does well. It never feels bloated or pretentious.
No, I'm not saying
it doesn't bog you down with constant exposition.
I promise.
Or take control away from the player.
Come on, I don't want to be here all night.
And the puzzles can be made challenging enough to actually require you to use that big pink thing in between your ears. Combined with a whole bunch of combat sequences where you can actually get killed quite easily if you're not careful. For people who aren't fans of old-school survival horror, I mean, I can see how you'd want to spend your time better elsewhere. And I mean, look, if you don't like that kind of thing, well, then that's fine too. This game's just not for you. And there's plenty other stuff going on anyway, with March's game calendar looking more packed than your mum's is on a Saturday night. But fans of the original, along with people who maybe appreciated the recent Resident Evil remakes, are going to find a fun game here of a similar nature.
Excellent. Thank you, madam.
Nothing else though, Alone in the Dark fans I think can finally be proud of the franchise again, and this might hopefully serve as some much needed medication after Illumination. Right, so let's chat about the MSI Titan 18HX.
As much as I think the Titan's a really, really good laptop, no, we're not listening about it. I already know the Titan's a good laptop, moving on.
There you go. There's Dad.
Yep.
Done for cheap.
Soldiers of the Imperium, today we shall storm
titties.
The heart of the heretics and root out their heresy.
Whatever you say, Commissar, mommy.
Most of us will not survive this battle, but be assured, our deaths will bring back the Emperor's light to this planet, and we shall do so in his glory.
Wow, look at her.
Now. Raise up your
yes,
weapons,
right.
And let us all charge onwards to victory!
That one's a woman in the front there, I see that.
And may the Emperor bless us with tons of loot.
Oh, there you go. Yeah! That's all you need to say. Woo! Loot! Speaking of, let's talk about victories.
Here you go.
One macrogi and mushroom risotto.
Oh boy.
A creamy delicacy from Ultramar, yeah. Made with macrogi and rice and gussied with special mushrooms I found.
Mushrooms, huh?
A well-deserved victory meal after fighting those green skins today.
Taste is satisfactory. Texture is smooth and creamy. And by the Emperor, these mushrooms are delectably medium, I say. Where'd you get them?
Simple. Growing on the orcs we killed.
Nope.
You'd be surprised how much protein orcoid fungi contained, mate.
Heretic!
Howdy there, folks. Tex of the Black Bands Legion here, and welcome to Space Station 14. Mm-hmm. I am your quartermaster for this evening.
Yes, he is.
So let's go ahead and just open our quartermaster's locker. We gotta put that quartermaster cloak on, because that is where you find yourself, the quartermaster's cloak. All right, let's go ahead and yell at everybody.
Just yell at them all.
Make sure people understand what's
yell
up.
Attention, yell them. Yell them.
Cargonia.
Cargonia.
This is the QM speaking.
Quartermaster.
Miners do not die. By that I mean our salvage crew. Your purpose in this life is to not perish. Also, I want to say to our cargo technicians, move freight, or I will whip you with a belt.
A real leader.
Without removing it.
Oh,
so,
shit.
There, handled it. All right.
Terrifying.
Let's move this freight, baby.
All right. Oop. That's on radio. Everyone heard that.
Oh, oops.
I was like, let's move this freight, baby. The LP checker says the whole
You're a freight, baby.
Let's move this cargo ship in here. Let's move it in here.
Oh, do it. Move it in there already. Do it. Damn it.
All right, and done. Says, I'm curious as to how you'd achieve that, sir. I see how it is.
Ain't liking obstinate. That.
Right, well, let's just move the freight. If I get a monkey or other disposable, can you demonstrate? No.
No.
That sounds gross. So let's move this freight onto the freight pads. No, almost. Almost. Oh, there you go. Good enough. All right, let's send this fucker off to the Wild Blue Yonder here.
That's right.
And there she goes, to the trading post. To the trading post. To the trading post.
To the trading post.
Move freight. That's your only job. No questions, no talk. Move boxes. You know what to do. You know what to do! I trust you. Now,
Browns.
I'm going to sit at the main
desk
and pretend to listen to people's problems. But I will not listen, because this is Cargonia.
Going on a salvage run, boss. Well,
you know, have a Cargonia.
That's right.
Now get me some salvage.
That's right.
Proceed to salvage. Ernesto asks, should we do bounties or just move freight? Whatever makes money.
It's about dinero. All the dinero. Essay, come exist. On.
The continuum of wealth generation on this station is an essential understanding to the economies.
Oh, so from the official Warhammer page. Mm-hmm. Someone asked, when did you make female custodians? Since the first of the 10,000 were created, there have always been female custodians. Actually,
and I'm going to ignore them or do this.
It's not going well. Yeah.
Nope. It's not
going well.
Big old cope.
I have a request, says the clown. Yes. What is it? I would like to request DIY telemetry for the plasma, please.
Fart.
What?
Fart.
A DIY chemistry set, but he has a speech impediment.
Oh.
So it's DIY chemistry set. And plasma. Well, plasma is at a premium. I'll let you know. That has to show up on salvage. But chemistry, Let me check. Let's double check here and see what we can get for the clown.
Chemistry crate. Chemicals, oh boy. Chemistry supply crate.
I can get you a chemistry crate. Whatever is in it is for you.
It's very exciting.
I need money. Lots of money. Lots.
Lots. How many?
How many spenders is this? I need money. Bring me
it's
money.
Hard to speak with a wish.
Or gold. Or
yes, it is, Robin.
People's teeth.
Ernesto.
I won seven. 7,000. All right. Oh, yeah. A joint. I need that.
A joint? You rolled him a joint.
Hey
it's
there,
like a doobie.
Says the Grey Titer. Greetings, Grey Titer mans. What can I do for you? Ah, they brought the lighter. Goddamn, Cardonia is
up.
On the ball today. Time to get high. I was talking with the captain and said you might need some bodies. Speak to the hop. Also, I'm going to make him smoke this joint.
Smoke the joint.
Also, prove you're not with Sec.
Oh, I mean, if you say so, Gene Skinner. Okay, buddy.
Sec? Uh-oh.
Smoke the weed.
Smoke the weed.
To prove you aren't a square. He's like, oh, jeez.
Got him.
All right. Now, go speak to the hop. And remember to breathe.
Okay, man.
Remember to breathe.
See,
you got a butter.
Cargo man now.
He's out there. Look at
I
that
will
catch.
Handle you once you get your new ID. Who took the salvage shuttle? That's a good question. We may have a new guy.
Mm-hmm. You may.
I was going to say cargo is looking radioactive.
Oh,
radioactive?
Boy.
Why?
What the fuck?
I'm going to remember what's in my mouth. Yay, smoking weed. Here you're 3,000th. What?
What? Well, holy shit.
Holy shit. All right. Okay.
Yo, what the fuck? How did he get all
you're
that
on.
Money?
I'll let you know. I'll let you know when it's here. Thank you, clown.
Why do you have all the money? What the fuck?
All right.
Holy
clown
shit.
Clown came through. Who knew? Who knew?
Holy
fucking
fuck.
Clown, man. Someone says, is there any way the HOP is a dog? Because all I see is a dog. He sees Ian and thinks that's the hop. He must be new or very high. All right. I did give him a bunch of weed.
All right.
That's fine. He'll be okay. Or he won't. He'll lose his brain.
He'll lose his brain.
None of my business. I just run freight. There we go. And she's docked right up.
Docked up.
Okay, where'd the gold go?
What the fuck? Where did the gold
Gene,
go?
Where'd the gold where, go? Where did the gold go?
I don't know.
Is it in here?
I know you know.
Oh, Tech says it. It's in the loot. There we
thought
go.
I was going to have to beat someone for theft already.
Gene Shekelstein.
At the end of the shift.
I got a thing
beginning.
For you just for that.
Right, let's see. Chemistry set. He wants a chemistry. Uh-huh. Okay, requires chemistry, chemical.
Once I contact my friends in the IDF, I'll show you a funny meme.
That's right.
And he'll
I'm gonna take you down, Weebler.
Eh.
You know.
You're gonna be paying me royalties.
What do we got here?
There. Done.
Oh yeah, the Grabblers.
Chemistry
That's right.
Set.
Grabblers.
Fucking Grabblers.
Oh, wow, the clown
oh,
left
I
some
do that
horrible
I remembered another meme.
That is the meat clown. They actually made that lunch meat for people. For those of you who want to know if that's based on a real thing, yes. Yes, it is. Hello, cargo beings. Hello, robot. Do you require assistance? Well, moving freight, sure. These salvage people might need help. I could use some help with delivery, you know. a delivery boy. Could use that. What do you require? Give me a minute when our salvage comes in. Yes, let's see. Let's see if we can get this clown his things. Okay, robot, we have a delivery for the clown. I love that salvage is dragging their salvage magnet in there. They've unbolted it and are just tracking, taking it.
Don't mind me, I'm looking
up
memes.
Okay. All these.
So, Gene, if you had to choose between wizard,
clown,
fighter,
go find the clown,
cleric,
and
or monk,
them
what would you
supplies.
Pick?
Attention, I would probably
clown.
Choose monk.
Your monk. Things from cargo have arrived.
Did you see what I just gave you there?
See.
You know Psych is right there, right?
Don't worry, Ernie.
Yes.
Your prayers
have been
answered.
To watch. I request a thylum and cargo. Hey.
I request
chemistry.
By the dozen.
Not asylum. That's extra. I can give you what desire. What can you do for me, clown? Can you make meth?
Yes.
Oh.
I don't want your fucking clown meat.
More. There's always more
meat.
You
want meth? Yes.
Clown meat?
Clown meat. Wow.
Always. Boring, says the clown. Oh, he yawned. Wow. Clown, make a drug factory, and I will
okay.
grant you Cargonian citizenship.
Oh.
We're going to get a drug lab going in
wow.
Cargo. Well, it wouldn't be the first time I've done that. But it might be the first time I've done that without an explosion. So, we'll see.
Wow.
Let's go this way, clown. Come on.
There, Weeb. I hope you enjoyed that.
We're
going
to go in here. We're going to make ourselves
a
drug
boy.
Lab.
Let me check it out.
Oh, security is coming in with their bush to hide in.
Attention, cargo. Clowns. Help the clown. If he fails to
he's
make
dying.
Grade A meth, break his legs. Got it?
Okay, clown. You're up. Hello, security being. Do you require assistance?
Dying.
He says no. His name is Perman
Briggs. I'm dragging you with me, mother trucker.
Well done. Sec, I know you're behind the bush. I see you. Do you require a donut or
what?
Coffee?
No.
He's like, what? No. I'm just cleaning it, he says. Right. So, donut or coffee? He's whispering, ready, boss, I'm already in position. All right, he just...
Attention.
A raccoon!
Raccoon, where?
Right there.
Well, you enjoy
that's a
your...
sneaky little bastard.
He is. Look at him.
Every time out. With them.
Have a productive shift. Thanks, robot. Access denied. We'll see about that. We will see about that. Fucking access denied. I'm just gonna bash these open. All you gotta do is get a crowbar and Gordon Freeman these things apart.
Hell yeah.
Hey Chief, look.
That's how I get through life.
Oh fuck.
Just with everything, really.
Nice.
What would Gordon Freeman do?
Bar.
That's right.
Well, the clown should have the chemicals to make
for you.
Anything.
And then you just, you know. And
he doesn't have a chem dispenser. Kim, is there anything I should focus on out there? Plasma and gold?
And gold.
And stuff that's worth money? All right, we busted that open. Well done, us. All right. Nice. Clown's doing his thing. Sec is enjoying his thing. Well, it looks like they're out there actually looting. All right, let's move some freight. Wow, they're building a bar.
Wow.
Uh-oh. Oh, God, the captain's here.
Uh-oh. Boo, Captain Buzzkill.
Eat fresh and freeze, he says. Ow. 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 That's not nice. I don't come in your job and shoot people.
Why not?
Jeez.
The captain is raiding your meth. We don't have any meth. Not yet. Come back later, and we can sell you meth. It's a shame when cargo turns to drugs. Why? It turns a profit. There's a jug of gold here. Yeah. Liquid gold.
Gold?
You want money? I'll help you. But you gotta go away. For a bit. I mean, we mostly wanted meth. Oh.
Well, come back with double E's, so you know.
I gotta get some stuff for the, okay.
Okay.
All right, Chad. I'm shit cleric from my class. If I get rolled, I blame everybody.
You can raid blame you us all. Later.
You can raid us later, quotes.
And then, you know, we all get high.
We'll get high.
I'm keeping the clown busy.
Slurp.
Do you want me to fire the clown?
You can't really fire the clown.
The clown is your problem. Do you understand?
All right.
This is true. Yeah. All right.
Oh, well, when you put it like that, on,
I think this puzzle's a failure.
Go check on science. I'm sure they're doing dangerous.
Help. I'm dying.
Look, we got a
it's
nice
Gene's fault.
Going.
He did it.
Nothing.
Yes, I did.
Nothing we're
I
doing
attacked his
evil.
Credit score anyway. And his life insurance.
Oh man, we get a lot of money now. Exotic seeds. I'm gonna order two of these. Actually, it looks like I'm ordering three. Then I can order gun.
Biggest
cargo.
Weakness.
Okay. What do you need to make meth to make security go away? What do you need, clown? Beakers?
$50 and a prostitute is all I need to make to solve this problem.
Okay. Let's see.
Trust me, I'm an expert in these matters.
Beaker.
There. I hear security stunning people.
As they do.
A cow.
As they should.
A cow.
Can do. Cow. You shall have three cows.
Three cow crates.
What's
for
in
you.
Here? Oh. Gauze and medical stuff?
Boo.
You might actually want to keep that.
Fringe.
This
Empire
clown keeps asking for stuff. I don't like what this clown is up to. He's asking for stuff that's off the meth recipe.
Oh no.
He wants bananium, which is horrifically radioactive, and a welding tank. I don't like his ideas.
Botany, your seeds are here.
Oh no.
He just keeps laying down this whoopee cushion so they're constantly making us fart. Mine?
Damn
he
it!
Says. Yes.
Yes, your botany.
All yours.
Make
Take
the
them
weed.
To botany.
Chef, your cows are here. Come get your cows.
There's a little mini cow there as well, which is nice.
Wow, mini cow.
We may turn that into a mascot
botany
or
cow.
Burgers, I don't know which.
Botany cow.
Please open the door.
Sorry, bonsai cow is what please, I meant to say. There. I got bonsai and botany confused in my head.
Come on. There we go. The cow's eating all our stuff.
Wow, a cow.
I like it. Fucking cows. Oh man, the power just died.
Oh no.
Damn it, right as I was about to get a fucking coffee.
Oh no, the
I'm
worst
gonna wait
time
for this
possible.
APC.
No, every time, man.
Come on. The power is out. God damn. He's got a
that's
lot of
that's homosexual rigmarole.
Oh. He stole a floodlight.
Wow.
We'll just load the freight in the dark. It's
this
never
one
stopped
does.
Cargonia.
Yeah,
freight
right?
Workers of
we've
the
all
world
been there. We've all been there.
Exactly.
All right, power came back on, but
that's
gravity
good.
Has died. I'm not sure when gravity's going to come back. I'm pretty sure when the generator finally gets more power, it'll kick back on, but it may not, which could be a problem.
Yeah, that's a real problem.
Could be a
I
problem.
Hope we actually get our gravity back.
Uh-oh.
Cargo, no. Did you get the drinks I got you? Yes, we got them. Thank you.
Yes.
I'm gonna drink this beer. Oh, there goes gravity back.
Oops, there goes gravity.
Let's check where we are with our cargo. Oh,
there's beer gravity.
We do have a lot of money. Excellent. Excellent. Wonder what sort of weapons we could just have. Let's see. You know?
An honest question.
We could order a bunch of handguns and just start handing them out. That sounds like a good idea. Let's do that. I'm just going to hand some guns out at the front desk. See, if you hand Glocks out to people...
That's bullshit. When I do it, you're arming terrorists.
Happens, right? You're not trying to foment rebellion.
Forment.
You're just handing a Glock out to people. For people.
For people.
Botany, you got 2 more crates in cargo. Come get them.
Sort of Christ, Botany, ordering things and then not wanting them. That's lazy.
Lazy.
Let's start building bats. I need more baseball bats for reasons.
Same.
You know, sometimes you need baseball bats.
Yeah, you never know when you need them.
Sometimes there's a union dispute.
You never know.
For you, the humor creature. Thank you. Find the clown.
Find that damn clown.
We'll probably need them. He's being arrested for being not humorous. Oh.
Wow.
Oh. Alright. Mm. Troublesome.
Troublesome. Very troublesome.
Troublesome. If we can't meet our math quota, Command's gonna beat the shit out of us. They're
yes,
gonna
they
be
are.
Like, you have all these lab supplies and promised us math, and when you don't deliver on people's
it's
math promises,
from fucking Breaking Bad.
Don't care for it. So, what we need to do
oh,
is
shit.
Get a way of
Gus
adequately
Ring.
Meeting the math requirements. Alright, there we go. Oh, fuck. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do.
Fuck.
Just move this forward. There we go. Cargo, can we get more plasma tanks?
Well, can we?
Maybe. Sure. If it's engineering asking for stuff, the answer is probably yes. But first I need to get my Glocks out. Time for cargo to help itself.
Screaming.
I'm just gonna open these right now. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Look like the clown got out of jail.
Wow. Making more meth.
That's good.
You're thinking too much about it.
For too long. It's not very funny. Okay, time to have pocket Glock. Alright. Nah. Stay strapped.
Stay strapped up, always.
The salvage crew needs a gat as well. They need some gatteries.
Gatteries.
Cargo, I need a microwave. Somebody has stolen mine. Ah, shit.
Ah, shit, dog. It's the captain.
Hi. The clown has a pile of things.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Oh, is that free floor meat? I'll have that. I'd like me some floor meat. I have a pocket full of Glocks.
Pocket full of
pocket
Glocks.
Pocket Glocks, as you will, you know? You know what? I'm going to seal this up. And I'm just going to take this away. And no one will ever know. No one will ever know that we have all these Glocks and cargo.
Wow.
Cargo Glocks. Boss, can you get us some anti-poison meds?
I can try.
Okay. Let's move this freight. Clown, return the microwave or use it. Gotta make sure. The botanist, the jerk, said he needed just one crate. Wow! What a mean guy. God damn it. Can't believe this. Guy says he only needs one. That's just not right. People are asking cargo why there's a Fulton beacon in front of SEC. Are y'all missing one? Unknown? I couldn't tell you. unless they're stealing stuff. There's fighting near science med sec. Oh, that sounds bad.
Oh, right, no.
Let's look into atmospherics. What do we
liquid
got?
Liquid nitrogen canister. Oh, no. Canisters?
Huh.
Cargo engineering. I see no plasma canisters for order. Sorry, guys. You are fucked.
You are fucked.
You have to have kind of a decent memory to play Cargo and remember what everyone wants.
Become ungovernable.
Slurping.
I hear someone drinking a lot of chemicals.
Oh, no.
I'm presuming this is the clown.
No.
All right, somebody says they need some in front of... What? What do you want? A gun?
Yes.
Ammo?
I'm after plastic.
Please. Don't have any.
We don't have any plastic, asshole. Nope, power's going out.
Also, disregard the ghosts. Let me check for plastic. Let me see. Do we have any? Oh, yeah. All right.
We do have plastic.
They can just have it. I don't want it. There. There.
Take it.
All I got. Now be gone!
Now be gone!
Alright, what do we have? We don't have enough money.
That's how I would act, too.
We need
leave.
More money.
Leave me alone.
I don't know what this
clown is
to do.
Get away!
That's
it,
right,
it
leave, alright, jeez. You had
it
your hour now, go.
Bad. Taking the bats, boss? I say we keep these, just in case. The bats may become useful later on.
They could.
They could very well become very useful later on.
The pistol magazines, yeah. Yeah. We should all have a bat. Or five. That's a cargo talking stick, that bat is.
Cargo talking sticks. You're gonna get some law laid on you from cargo, boy.
Right.
I see an abandoned ship.
You ever hurling or dueling loots? You're about to.
Machine frame on shuttle. Oh, yeah, we're pulling an engine out.
Oh, boy.
Huh. Hey, salvage. Let's pull this, Wait.
Wait.
Do you hear... beeping?
Yes, there's beeping. Is there a bomb? Nope.
I hear beeping.
Uh-oh. I don't like that.
Just making sure. Sometimes the beeping isn't what you think it is. Okay. I saw a broken ship. Let's steal it. Stay
yes.
on board. Let's go do this. Hail Cargonia.
Hail Cargonia.
Time to steal a ship.
Hail Cargonia.
I don't think the ship stealing is going to go to plan.
Stealing things
time
in cargo
left.
Is not,
That's quitter talk to
exactly.
me, Gene.
I'm just saying. We'll see.
That's impossible. Quitter talk.
You just gotta love what you do here. A little bit of this. It's like, wait, the thing we just ripped apart? Yeah, yeah, don't worry. I
don't
can
worry
pull
about
it in. We can loot the whole thing.
That's right.
There we go.
Nice.
And we pull it all the way in. And it becomes our friend. One time we heard a fun beeping on the station, and everyone thought it was harmless.
Oh, no.
But it was, in fact, not. Okay. Holy fuck.
Holy shit, look at all the stuff on there.
What happened in here?
Oh, look at all that free shit.
What the fuck? What is this? There's a corpse, too.
Oh, boy.
Okay. Loot it all.
Loot it
up. That's what we do. We're just going to loot it all.
That beeping.
Yep, and taking that in there.
I don't trust that beeping.
We're taking everything.
Never trust
oh
the beeping.
Oh, my God. Mm-mm. There's just piles of stuff. A bomb suit crate?
Yeah. Oh.
We're taking that in case we need it.
Oh, shit. Oh, my God. That beeping was not good. It was a bomb.
It was a bomb.
It was.
It wasn't just my... Oh, my God. I just trapped
Always
myself
has been.
In here. No, I didn't.
He lived.
Yes, I did. I cannot...
You can't
Wait.
Leave?
Crowbar. Yes.
Well, thank God, Gordon Freeman.
I may
Freeman.
Live yet. Okay. Massive bomb and cargo. Wow. Okay. Not exactly our best day here.
He lived, though.
Wow. So the clown didn't make grade A math.
No.
Yeah.
He made a bomb.
Yeah, he didn't. He made
a bomb.
Mistake. Yes? Yes, he did. Oh, man. Well, shit. Yeah. Yeah, the clown.
The clown.
Well, okay. Let's, fix cargo and hope nobody notices. They're gonna notice. They're definitely gonna notice there's a hole in cargo. Do we recover the clown? No.
No.
No, we do not. Guys, cargo exploded.
Yes, it did. Massively.
Clown did it. Alright, let me get the oxygen mask and such.
Do it up.
Alright, well,
get
I got a basic
mask.
Pressure suit.
Right. Like,
hey, your department blew up. Yeah,
hey, your department blew up.
Yeah.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
We've all been there.
I've been there multiple
Who times. Who hasn't blown up?
Clown blew it up.
Clown blew it up. He blew it up.
Clown's dead.
Yes, he
Good.
Is.
Good. All right. Now I need to put my floor back together. Definitely looks like a bit of a chemistry oops.
Yeah, it does.
That also took out a big chunk of the station. Oh, my God. It took out a massive chunk of the station.
It did. Jesus, look at the station.
Yeah, there's that cow.
The cow is dead.
There's security.
No, no. Not security,
blew
my
up
favorite.
Almost to engineering, which is amazing. So, wow. Clown's dead.
Yeah, no kidding.
I suppose we can drag Sec here. He's got his cigarette still in his mouth. All right.
But he's dead as fuck.
Start fixing the floor. Best you can.
Wow.
I'm going to blame this on the clown.
Yes.
Even if it wasn't the clown.
Yeah. That's what I would do.
It is the clown's fault. All right, three more videos, then we're done.
Oh, God. Not the carp. Not like this.
Oh, he died to a carp? Wow. All right. Dragon Tamer time. More Dragon Tamer. Shooting Star.
Oh my God, it's Miss Yuko!
Miss Yuko, please sign my book!
Dragon Curry.
One at a time, please.
Your rendition of Japanese classic dishes are amazing!
I can impress my wife with cooking because of ya!
I love your katsu recipe!
Senorita, mind if I ask if you are free later? Tell that bodyguard of yours you need a little break, and I will treat you for dinner tonight.
Nope, sorry, I'm taken. And this actually
Her voice changed.
Husband. He's also the CEO.
The barrierism is at a quarter bendo.
He's speaking Spanish to him? Her voice changed, though, I heard that. Anyway, here's this weeb. This one's just for you.
Oh, just for me?
Yeah, here we go.
Hello, sir. It's already 3 a.m.
Sir.
Could you please lower the volume of your music?
Excuse that line. Sir.
Did you just call me? Sir.
Here it goes. Wait. Booba!
Do I look like a guy to you? You little piece of shit!
Why don't you show me the error of my ways and your
she
room or dinner?
Looks tall as shit, too. Now, God mode on, Levra. One more Space Station 13 before we go. Here we go. Catch that beat. Did you just call me, sir? Just the huge tilts. That one was just for you, Weeb. Hope you appreciate it.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Oh, I may have pissed off a bunch of trannies on Twitter.
Sounds great. Sounds great.
Like, ooh. Wow. I commented on that post, and one of them on there was like, "This is a big win for the community." And I'm like, "It does not speak for us. What do you mean by it?"
Dead rats.
I said what I fucking said.
Well, I think a lot of people are gonna keep going away from Warhammer for a long time. I don't think anyone's come back anytime soon.
Right? It's just ridiculous.
It's hemorrhaging a lot. Has no rats. Come here. Gasp.
No.
Actually, having voices is nice. I know you probably can't hear them fully because of the music, but there are voices actually from the characters.
Damn it, he got me!
It will work. We gotta become. It's invisible. Bowser. DNA infuser? Oh boy. Gives you unique organs depending on the animal. Oh boy. Oh, is he fusing with a rat? Screams.
Check what my heart is.
Rat heart.
Rat heart up. Move a rat heart gives 50 resistance to everything. 50 resistance to everything? Holy shit. Can feel your mutated rat heart being removed from your chest.
How dare you?
Two more
times. I paid good money for that.
Whoop. Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Damn it, Gene!
You a question. Greg. Oh, got him.
Got him.
And murdered. He did. Now he's the brig. Actually, no, he's the general. Whatever. Taking control. Gunman in armory. Brig, help.
I think he's gone, sir.
It's music, it's really good.
Hell yeah, it slaps.
I'm sure it's actually in the Leopard's actual video to tell what music it is. One piece of Enterprise. So if you like it, go look there. Definitely subscribe to Leverage Channel if you enjoy the Space Station 13 content.
So when's the next Skinny Jean Radio?
That will be this Thursday.
Oh.
Yeah. It'll be a Skinny Radio this Thursday.
I like my version, but... You've turned into Skinner Radio. Give me your shekel. BlackRock owns a share of us.
Skin FM 6.67. 667 is the neighbor of the beast. Yeah, that was you guys. Yeah, here's some slipping noises. I'm taking a drink of some water.
Ooh.
And totally wasn't the blood of my enemies.
Which sort of IPA is water? I've never heard that one before.
No. I'm having some body armor. I'm trying to punch. I didn't have anything to drink tonight. I promise. Fine. I did think it was at this point. I have a block of tequila, but I didn't do that. I didn't do that. Local blood brothers ascended to godhood. Oh boy. And regret about their actions.
Why does he have an axe?
He's got an axe for his brother, too, it would seem. Axe up. May I ask you a question?
When I axe you...
Cough. He's a moth. Sneaky.
You're a moth.
Maybe I am.
I fucking knew it. Fog person confirmed.
Squeak, squeak, squeak.
I always knew you gave off them Bugman vibes.
Yes, moths do technically squeak. They can do that through, like, weird passages of tubes within their body. Can I have that gun?
Why do you want the gun?
Because the gun is good.
If I give you a gun, you're just gonna shoot somebody with it.
That's right. Boris.
Booties.
What about my hamburger? penis.
It is a fucking slapper, that's for sure. Certified Hood Classic? Maybe.
Drive around your lowrider with this on, damn.
You'll pull at least one bitch.
That's right. At least
guaranteed.
One she got. One hyena.
And if you don't, it's because Porky sabotaged you.
Probably cut your brake line too, I think. Had to stop. Gotta just jump out of the vehicle at that point.
I mean, that's the smartest option, honestly.
Bye. Fight.
Kill him.
Fight, fight. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Can't leave my block. Catalyst here. Oh, well, let's go. I hit Ernesto. Wow, wow. Oh, shit, dog. Here we go. Time to leave. Uh-oh. Oh, this music sounds even worse. This music sounds like it slaps too, damn.
I got a bad feeling about this.
That's Doom music. That's a remix of a Doom song, I think. Sounds like it. Oh my god, they're all on it. I forgot his sunglasses. Oh no.
Damn it.
I think he'll be dying. From my words, no escape. Calls. My only weakness is 100% drugs. He's alive the fuck out. Brother to the shuttle. Just keep wailing. Why is he alive? Space him? Space him? Slink him? I think that's a snake person. This music a lot still. He just did. You are just like me.
For real.
Boris, you absolute Giga Chad. I don't use a toxin, what? Creatures. Jesus.
Fear.
Almost there. Have you tried max capping Boris? Do not remove his suit. I look like I have a max cap up my ass.
Yes.
I say it's funny. Gags. Slit his throat. Damn, they're gonna kill him. Are you even trying? Still have tried harder? He's still alive? Standing here, I realize You were just like me on the lyrics.
No!
Tyranny trying to make history. Who's to judge?
Who's to judge?
His BB. The right from wrong. Nanorats, son! Nanorats! Man, I love Metal Gear Solid Revengeance! Yup, yup! Holy shit! He's still alive? Still not fucking dead. Oh my god. The screen getting fuzzy though.
It sure is.
Zoom. Yeah, zoom. He is holding on. Holy fuck. In white. In light. Yep, ghost. Holy
going
shit.
Going ghost!
Holy shit, look at all the dead people around him. Holy fuck.
Oh god.
There's a clown. I am here. Blood loss. How do I slit throat? Defoot.
Get wrecked, orc.
Leland, no. Wow. Blood loss.
That was fucking
crazy.
Wild.
It was. All right, everybody. With that, we come to the end of Fans of Fiction. I'd like to thank Weeb for joining me as always.
The end?
Yes, we are at the end of Fans of Fiction for tonight. That will be it. Don't forget the movie caption contest, movie Pictionary, movie Handmare are going on in the arcade station of the Heretic Unlimited Discord, so be sure to play those when you're not busy in the internet. The Easter event, I believe, is over, but if you have the stuff there from it, you can definitely still use it. Besides that, as well, Jenny will probably be showing something in the Discord after this. I'm pretty sure she'll show some American Horror Story Season 1, where you just started that yesterday. Besides all that, tomorrow back here at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time will be a Case of the Monday, so be sure to tune in for that. All right, everybody, I will see you guys later. Y'all have a good night. Bye-bye.